I think the use of mobile technology is really going to change in the next few years, predominantly through how businesses will start to use the technology. I think we've all become quite familiar as consumers with using our phones to engage in quite a range of different services, but actually businesses using this technology internally is really going to pick up pace in the next few years, and we're going to start seeing a lot of innovation coming from how businesses engage with their employees, how they improve their processes, how they manage to cut costs, and mobile technology is really going to be at the key of that. So mobile first is very much a process that we go through in terms of designing specifically for the mobile device being the primary form of engagement. So often for things like mobile responsive websites, people will always start assuming what it looks like on a desktop and then shrinking it down to see how that then looks on a mobile. For mobile first, you're considering the mobile user at the very beginning of the process that you're looking at. So you're looking at how it's optimized, you're looking at how the content is going to work for them, and you're considering the approach that they're going to have being on a mobile device, what they're looking for specifically as a user, rather than just taking a whole heap of content and shrinking it down so it stacks on top of each other nicely. Well, a desktop site is still very much needed, but the majority of traffic is now coming from mobile devices, and a lot of brands, a lot of businesses are seeing people accessing their site, accessing their information predominantly through a mobile device. We've been working with Fujifilm recently, and again, they've been getting a lot of traffic from Snapchat advertising, and all of that traffic is coming through on mobile devices. So it's very, very important for them that they're considering and taking into account what that customer journey is going to be like for someone who's coming in from a mobile device, rather than just taking it as a shrunken down version of what the desktop is. So the customer journey is very much the process at which someone navigates through the site. It's the flow of information, it's leading them to certain other places in the site. Basically, it makes sure that there are no dead ends, that you're doing really well with things like signposting, taking them through, that there's a logical sense of progression for them in terms of content and where things are going. And again, optimizing that content for the mobile device potentially. So rather than taking three paragraphs of text, actually on a mobile you might only be interested in that first paragraph. So again, optimising the content specifically for the medium that someone is coming through on. Cloud services are really involved in mobile technology. People often don't think about it, but they just see the app and what's happening directly on their device. But behind all of the popular apps that we use, things like Facebook and Twitter and all of the other app services, there's always a huge cloud program or sense of cloud service provision behind that app, powering its data, powering some of the processes that it goes through. So this is just one way in which the cloud is taking a really big step forward in terms of adoption in the coming years, really. When you're outside of a Wi-Fi zone or you don't have data connection to your app, the emphasis is really coming down to app developers to make sure that they're providing an eloquent way for you to engage with the app still, even if there isn't a data connection, even if it is heavily reliant on cloud services or data from online, rather than just a big screen that says, you haven't got any internet access at the moment. We're seeing things like local caching of data, where the information is stored on the device, and then at the next opportunity when it's connected in, it's then posted back up to the server and it connects through that. But it still gives the user the ability to interact with the app and maybe do some of the services that it's offering. So really that emphasis on the app developer to provide that offline service is becoming much greater emphasis when looking at how you build them in production. At Greendog, we've been using quite a range of different mobile technology for clients. We've seen businesses coming up with really innovative ways for solving problems in their business. One recent example is a printer supplier who, when an error code happens on the machine, It generates a QR code, and then we've built an app specifically to read that data. It's got all of the error information in it. That then gets sent off to their support services, and they've got a huge range of data about what is happening with that machine, where it is, everything that they need to know, so they can offer a much faster, better and proactive support service to their customers. Through how we can improve areas like health and safety by delivering improvements in mobile technology and the data that can be accessed through that. There's really been quite a range of different solutions that are available, and we're really keen to try and promote how mobile technology can really push forward cost savings and improvements in engagement across a range of different businesses. When we're building an app, we consider iOS and Android as the two major platforms. I think between the two, you've got over a 99% market share there. But specifically, we build our app technology in a way that is portable into other providers such as Windows phones or BlackBerrys. So if there was a specific requirement from a business where potentially they've just bought into providing their staff with Windows phones, for example, then it would be relatively easy for us to then take that and spread it across the board. But definitely iOS and Android are your two massive market. I think the big thing that we'll start to see in the next couple of years is a big push towards augmented reality. I think some of the big players are already starting to throw their hat in the ring in terms of how we start to engage with things like augmented reality. And that's different to virtual reality, where you've got a complete overcast of what you see. But augmented reality is when you see an overlay of your natural environment. And very much how we interact with things like mapping technology, even things down to viewing information on a site that you're visiting or anything like that, you'll be able to see a lot more information that is contextually appearing in your natural environment. And that will be through mobiles, it will be through other wearable technology that will undoubtedly start to take a much greater play forward in the coming years. But in terms of how students going into the marketplace can really make a difference, they've got this great understanding of mobile technology. They can see things in a fresh way. They're not stuck in the rut of we do things this way and this is the process we're doing. That really gives them the opportunity to see things in a fresh light, to take mobile technology forward. And introduce a whole range of savings and cost benefits into any business, really.